It's showtime.
Hey, welcome to Did You Watch Survivor Last Night? My name is Jake Scheidel. This is a podcast about reality television and friendship in which I ask my best friend, Thomas Powell, if he did indeed watch a certain reality show. Hey, Thomas, how you doing? Gobble,
Jake,
gobble.
Gobble, gobble. It's December now. That means it's another 3.5 weeks of having to listen to Christmas music.
Oh.
And I can't wait.
Oh, you're cutting it off on Christmas Day? You don't let it run over a little bit? Into the next?
I mean, I don't start listening to it until, like, the week of Christmas, but
oh.
I'm not going to be able to avoid it in public spaces.
I thought you were saying you personally are going to start listening to it for only 3.5 weeks. But yeah.
Less. I will be listening to it for less.
There might
be, like, one day.
It's been happening already. It's been happening since Halloween.
I'll listen. Well, yeah, but like,
sorry,
I try to avoid that.
Well, okay.
So yeah, there will be one day where I'll be like, you know what? I do want to hear "Last Christmas" by Wham, or the "Last Christmas" cover by Carly Rae Jepsen.
Yeah.
And then you know maybe I want to listen to "Father Christmas" by the Kinks.
Do you like?
Maybe I want to listen.
Do you like
to
"Last
Christmas"?
I do. I feel like people, that's a really polarizing Christmas song.
Some people hate it, especially the Wham version, and I think that the Wham version is the best version.
It's
of the
so
song.
Good. It's like
very
apple pie,
good.
Speaking of Thanksgiving. It's so good.
That song fucking whips. The little drum fills in it are great.
Yeah.
It's good.
It's a good song. You know what we should write for this show? Last Chris-miz. For the Christmas season.
Of course.
Which,
oh,
unfortunately,
God,
we cannot celebrate this year because it is the year of Sandra.
It's the year of Sandra. And also, there aren't any more Christmas movies. He's got to make another one.
Well, yeah, we're giving him a whole other year to make another Christmas movie.
Yeah, we're giving him... Yeah, this is an ultimatum.
How are Ms. and Maurice not making Santa's baby while Maurice is pregnant with their new baby? And then it comes out and it's a baby Santa or something. Because babies are very hip now, thanks to Yoda.
It's true. They're back in baby. They were up for a little while with Baby Groot. Then people got sick of them. Now it's back with Baby Yoda.
It's really like a peaks and valleys thing. It was like Baby Groot was a peak,
thing.
And then there was
not a
nothing.
Focus group that produced both of these things.
There was Baby Yoda, but like even before that, I think the greatest peak of baby fever was probably Baby Geniuses.
Oh,
babies
baby
were so hip back then. Thomas, did you watch Island of the Idols last night?
I grew up on that cash money. Bling bling was well known to flash money.
Jake, are you aware that there's a line in Baby Geniuses where Christopher Walken is like, have you worn gold-plated diapers? I saw that movie in the theater. I'm just now realizing that there are a lot of really bad movies that I saw in the theater as a kid.
Yeah, probably most of them, right?
I was talking to people about this. I don't think this is a bad movie, but I do remember that because we were both children and it was a movie that we saw together as children. We went and saw the Doug movie.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
I don't remember anything about the movie. I just remember that I went with you. And I think we were like 7 or 8.
That sounds about right. Yeah.
And, but anyway, no, I was talking and because I was joking with somebody about, you know, all the movies that you can watch now with Disney Plus.
So many movies.
They texted me, you can see Disney's The Kid. And I was like, saw that shit in theaters already, buddy. First day I was out there for Bruce Willis. And then I was like, I'm just now thinking about it. And I also saw Snow Dogs in theaters.
Snow Dogs is a good movie. Do not start talking shit about Snow Dogs. Snow Dogs is fantastic.
Do you remember anything about that movie? Because
yeah,
I remember
that Cuba Gooding Jr. is in it, and it's very good.
Okay, do you remember any like details? Because there's one specific thing about that movie that I remember.
I'm trying to remember if the dogs... Could the dogs talk?
He has... it's like Kangaroo Jack in that they can't, and he has a hallucination where the dogs talk.
That was very hip and back in the early 2000s, huh?
People loved... They loved having that in... So they could put it in the trailers to trick people into going to see the movie.
I can tell you a lot about Snow Dogs, actually, Thomas. Like the fact that it was directed by Brian Levitt, and that it stars Cuba Gooding Jr., and James Coburn in one of his final roles. Did you even know that, Thomas?
I didn't. I knew that Cuba. I knew that Cuba was in it.
Did you know that it was released January 18th, 2002? Did you even?
Yeah, that sounds about right. I was probably too old to be seeing that movie then.
Oh, apparently we have different grandmas. I'm pretty sure my grandma took us to see this movie.
Why did I want to see that movie at age 11? I don't know.
Because you
man.
Love snow and you love dogs. What kind of question is that? Because
that was around the same time that I saw, like, that I went and saw, like, School of Rock in theaters. And that was, like, good.
School of Rock was 2003 or 4? 2003, right?
It was either 2002 or 2003.
I think it was 2003. Did you know that Snow Dogs was inspired by the book Winter Dance, The Fine Madness of Running the Iditarod by Gary Paulsen? Did you even know that, Thomas?
I didn't know that, but it makes sense that they based... I'm sure that was, like, the source material for them to make the Iditarod, you know, they could be accurate about, you know, what it takes.
I do remember...
to run the Iditarod.
I remember the Iditarod being very popular around this time.
Anyway, Jake, we're getting away from the joke that I remember from the movie, okay? And that's the important thing.
Okay.
And I don't know why this has stuck with me for so long from a movie.
Did you even
I
know?
Don't even think I liked as a child.
Did you even know that Graham Greene played Peter Yellowbear?
I didn't, but I do now. Mm-hmm. I think he's kind of like a rich asshole in that movie. And this
Cuba?
Is like a thing that. Yeah, I think this is like a thing that
humbles
him.
Oh, he's a dentist based out of Miami, Florida. You asked me if I know any facts about Snow Dogs. I know so many very good facts about Snow Dogs.
He really likes... They have a running thing where he likes blue cheese, and then in the hallucination when the Snow Dogs talk to him, his grandma also comes up, and she's like, I made a batch of my famous blue cheese cookies, and he's like very happy to eat the blue cheese cookies. And just the thought of a blue cheese cookie has stuck with me for a
long
time.
My mouth is
watering. It's very upsetting.
I think that sounds great.
It's
I would
fucking
love
gross.
That.
I like blue cheese. I just, not in a fucking cookie.
Blue cheese is good in everything, and you're wrong to think
so
otherwise.
Anyway, yeah, given Snow Dogs a big thumbs down, blue cheese cookies are gross. Fuck that movie. I will not be subscribing to Disney Plus solely because I do not want to have the option to watch it.
You have the internet. You always have the option to watch Snow Dogs, and I can't believe you've fasted up this many times. Snow Dogs, not a Christmas movie. You know, it is a Christmas movie. Santa's Little Helper? Wild Dogs?
Wild Hogs.
Well, I don't think he's in Wild Hogs, is he?
Yes.
The Miz is in Wild Hogs?
You didn't see him. He's an extra in one of the scenes.
You know, just... Early on, you got to take all the work you can get. I get it. Thomas, I don't think you ever answered the question. Did you watch Survivor Island of the Idols last night?
Yes, I did.
Thanks for answering. This episode was called Bring on the Bacon. I think a good episode title.
Pretty good episode title, in my opinion.
I think best one yet of the season.
Yeah, maybe.
What do you think would be better? Can you even name one?
I don't know. That's why I'd have to look at all of them again.
Okay.
I'm not willing to make such a bold declarative statement yet when I haven't looked at all the facts.
Fair enough. Okay, on the Lumiwaku beach, Karishma is excited to finally have options. That line right there was like, uh-oh, Karishma's the target the rest of the episode, isn't she? Elizabeth feels stranded. Lauren, Dean, Tommy... target Karishma and Nora, but Tommy is suspicious of Elizabeth. And then the Island of the Islands boat shows up to tell them to have a unanimous decision to send somebody to the Island of the Islands. And they decide to send Lauren. Were you excited that Lauren is going to Island of the Islands?
I did not have an opinion about Lauren going to Island of the Islands. I was like, all right, let's see what happens. That was how I felt about it.
I haven't formed an opinion on Lauren all season.
No, it was nice for her to get a lot of, you know, screen time this episode. I feel like I have a better handle on her as a player now.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how far she gets, because she's smart, I feel like.
This episode was a very impressive thing that she unfortunately did not totally stick the landing on.
Sandra and Boston Rob eat papaya until the chicken bites Sandra's hand. It was very funny.
The best part of the episode.
Yep. Best part of the season. As soon as
I watched it, I was like, yeah, maybe even the entire season. I was like, nothing's going to top this.
Yeah. Lauren has to predict the next immunity winner and will win an idol good for the next two tribal councils if she does. Boston Rob lets her end up picking two of the people left, so she picks Nora and Elizabeth. I think very obvious choice for both of those people.
Sure.
When they showed the challenge, I was like, oh, it's gotta be Nora, then. I wasn't the only person to think so.
And it did gotta be Nora.
At the camp, Dean decides he will play the legacy advantage that Jamal gave to him. So he makes a fake version of it. Here's a question. How has Dean made it this far in this game?
I think people just started ignoring him.
It seems that way, yeah. Yes, that makes sense.
I think maybe people think that he's a good person to take to the end as a goat.
But he...
Because what has he done?
He played an idol correctly when somebody else told him to. He made some shots in tribal immunity challenges. And he's really good friends with... Kelly. So there's that.
Who's not... Well, I mean, she's on the jury,
jury, so... I mean, that could be a vote for him, but I'd be surprised. Bless you.
Excuse me.
So, Lauren comes back...
I'm just allergic to bullshit.
Okay. Lauren comes back and explains what the next challenge will be, and also explains that they can also win... Or they can play, or they can eat waffles and pancakes and whatever else comes in a breakfast at a Holiday Inn. She tells Tommy that she got to bet on the people to win, so they have to talk up the food so that more people will play. It was a very, very smart move. Very smart. Is this what you were saying, her good plan this
episode? Yeah, I thought she set this whole thing up perfectly.
Mm-hmm. So the only people to play the challenge were Karishma, Elizabeth, and Nora. What if Karishma had won this one, huh?
That was my immediate thought, was like, oh man, it would be... if they edited this so that Karishma, you know, they could show it failing because Karishma won.
Yeah.
But yeah, I would... I never like fully got there because I was like, Karishma's not going to win.
Clearly. But it would be a great storytelling moment if she had... everybody else chooses to eat breakfast. Karishma drops almost immediately and starts crying when Jeff asks her why, and she says that she can handle feeling like a failure. Seems like a redemption arc story, huh? For the winner's edit she's getting, huh?
Yeah, sure.
All right. You know what? There's not many seats left on the Karishma boat, so...
No, I think she's... this was a... She had a very good episode.
Yes. Nora wins the challenge unsurprisingly and holds onto the ball for as long as possible to give people more time to eat. It's just a nice little moment for...
That was nice.
...the people in the challenge.
Oh, also, the other best part of the episode was the complete lack of reaction the reveal of the breakfast food and Jeff being very confused.
That was funny. I could tell he was very much playing it up, because obviously he knows what happened, but it's still very fun. Jeff Probst, good host. We've said it before, and we'll say it again. Good job hosting, Jeff Probst.
One of the best in the business.
Back at camp, Tommy believes the vote will be for Karishma, but then says, why would I vote out somebody I can easily beat at the end? Tommy, interesting thought. Elaine wants Karishma out. Elizabeth says, I just pray Karishma doesn't have an idol. So she and Nora go through her bag. But guess what? She does. This is a very exciting episode. Dan tells Karishma to vote for Janet. Karishma tells Elizabeth she wants to take out Dan. But then Dan comes over and questions them about it. So Karishma contemplates playing her idol. This is a very exciting series of events, in my opinion.
Yeah, I thought so too.
Thanks for listening to this very involved analysis of this show. Thomas?
The show was good. Yeah, no, they, you know, I mean...
Yeah.
I'm at least enjoying watching this, if not fully invested in it, you know?
Yes, I can understand where you're coming from. I'm just happy because my person got a really good episode.
Yeah, no, it's good. I like the way that the better players are kind of coming together.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what it's time for before we talk about the better players coming together?
What is it time for?
It's those wildlife shots.
Oh, of course.
So we got a crab. Who doesn't know about crabs? We got a fish. Who doesn't know about fish? But we also saw the return of Thomas's son, Roland the Bat.
He's back.
It's been a long time since we've seen that boy. What's been going on with Roland the Bat, your son, Thomas?
I love my boy. I've been wondering the same thing. I haven't seen him, you know, since you did.
Oh, good point. He probably got upset that you got so invested in your three sons in that video game.
That's true.
And so he felt jealous and had to leave.
You know what? I'm sorry, buddy.
You know what? He's back.
Sorry you feel that.
He's
I'm
back
sorry
now.
You feel that way.
He was a bat boy before, but now he may be a bat man.
Batman.
Yep. That's a headcanon.
This is a nerd podcast.
It's a nerdy show. We're really only talking about nerd stuff.
No girls allowed.
You're telling me. There's always a fear of a girls' alliance. Not here, because there's no girls on this show.
Buddy, it's 2019. For another month. Girls can be annoying nerds too.
Whoa!
Just putting that out there. That's feminism.
What about what happens in 2020?
Then they're not allowed anymore. This is the last month that they're left. It's been a good run, ladies.
So we're going to celebrate women.
Come to an end.
We're going to celebrate women for a year and then we'll go back to not paying attention anymore. Just like our favorite corporation, the World Wrestling Entertainment.
Just not listening to all the nagging that they're doing. I only drink Dr. Pepper 10.
Well, it's not for women, so that makes sense.
Yep, that's... They don't make it anymore, but I find a way
hey,
to
Thomas,
get it.
I think now would be a good time to do a quick bottle check. What are you drinking over there?
Dr. Pepper 10,
oh,
buddy.
Same here.
That's all I drink. I'm very dehydrated.
Well, you know what? You know what's for women? Water. That's why they both start with W. Hey, this is a bad bit.
It is the best bit that we've ever done. I hate that you said that.
Elizabeth at Tribal Council now said that she played during the challenge because she wanted immunity. Karishma said she wanted to challenge herself. That's something people with winners edits say. Nora wanted people to eat. That's very nice. And I kind of want Nora to win now.
Yeah, that was very sweet of her.
Karishma says, it may be someone on your own side of the trenches who slits your throat. Thomas, you always...
Sometimes it be your own people.
Sometimes it be your own people. You love the metaphors that they always come up with at Tribal Council. Did you enjoy the trenches metaphor throughout this one?
No, I hated it.
But you love it. You loved the pilots and passengers last season.
Oh, the best.
You loved the David and Goliaths of the season before that. And now this is two people on the same side of a trench. Or on opposite sides of trenches. The metaphor was lost on me. I'm not a smart person.
We found love in a hopeless trench.
There we go. I think.
What if we kissed at the trench?
I think it's of all of the metaphors, probably the best one for this game in particular. The game of Survivor.
That, huh?
I mean, it makes more sense than pilots and passengers. That doesn't mean shit. That's just a catchy phrase that the producers stumbled upon. More like producers and pilots and passengers.
21 pilots and passengers.
Good one. 21 guns.
I'm not familiar with that. That's old people music. I only know new music.
It's Green Day. From
I've never heard of that before.
Green Day actually started in the 80s.
You're an old man. You were, yeah, you turned the age that you are slightly before I did. Mm-hmm. So, as you were quick to point out during our season one, you know, coverage that we did. Mm-hmm. So you're like an old man. I'm like a cool young guy.
What was the first season that was on when you were born of the show? If you're so cool and young, can you even name what season of Survivor they were on when you were born if you're so young?
Oh, I can't even. Survivor's just always been there as far as I'm concerned.
Oh wow, you're so young.
Because I'm a teen.
Congratulations on your youth. Carissa said that thing about trenches that you loved. Then Jeff asks Dean why he decided to eat instead of play, and he says a sentence that sure did make it into the episode. He said, "I was in a peculiar position, as you'll see later tonight." Why not?
What?
Why not just play the dumb thing that you made fake? He's like trying to be so mysterious, and it's so unnecessary. Just like, I don't know. He never learned how to talk at tribal council, I feel like.
Apparently not.
And then they talk about trying to get the vote together, and Tommy says it's like trying to get 8 people to agree on their favorite restaurant. Applebee's, obviously. How is this even a debate with this cast?
So, Jeff, like, so what you're saying is it was easy because we all love Applebee's. And then he looked into the camera.
Wink. Get the blue shark in the glass. I don't remember what it was called. Bluefin?
My favorite drinks and hot eats.
They vote. Dean plays his fake legacy advantage. Karishma plays her idol. So then Lauren plays hers. And Karishma got 7 votes.
Was there any strategic purpose for the fake thing?
For Dean's plan?
Yeah.
So I believe his thinking was, if this is fake, everybody thinks it's fake, so I'll play it now, because you can play it at 9 or 6. I'll play it now, everybody will think I don't have it, just in case if it is real, I can play it at 6. But it's still fake. It's still very obviously fake, so I don't think it's not going to work in his favor. But I want to think that was his thinking, so that his threat level is diminished, if there was any at all.
Threat level is at midnight.
Yes. So Grisham gets 7 votes. Janet and Beth each get 1. Does that make sense? That reasoning for Dean?
Yeah, I suppose I can kind of see that.
I mean, it's not a great move, but given what he's given, I guess it makes sense. They revote and Elizabeth gets all the votes. Good for them. There's only so many people left. I watched this with my mom in person for the first time in a long time.
Oh, fun. What did your mom think?
She had a lot of questions just about the mechanics of the game, I feel like. But that's nothing new. She had a lot of questions about Dean's legacy advantage. I was like, no, it's fake. Jamal made it and gave it to him. And she was like, wait, so is it actually fake? Or is the one he's making now fake? I was like, they're all fake. Other than that, I think she was very happy with Karishma playing the idol, but she also said throughout, she complains so much.
Karishma does complain a lot.
Well,
and she always looks like she's gonna cry.
Probably because she is. And that's why she's getting the winner's edit and the check at the end. You want to hear about the challenge? It's almost done.
Yeah, let's hear it.
So one person had to saw a rope that was holding the other team in a basket over the water. The Americans lost the challenge and sent in Nani and Ashley to elimination. The two of them had to run through a really long trail and then solve a puzzle. And no surprise, Ashley won the puzzle. And next week is the final, and it's going to be intense. And that's the challenge every week on MTV.
MTV, music television.
Love it.
That's their slogan.
Yeah. Use the hashtag #YasQueen for the year of Sandra on all the social media.
I want my MTV.
Yeah, they used to say that. Now everybody has MTV and everybody's on MTV. Back in my day, it was only the Mark McGrath-looking guy from the early seasons of The Challenge. He was the only one.
He innovated it.
At one point in the episode of The Challenge, Leroy said, "This game's been really tough for me because I lost my best friend, which is bananas.
Because I really want my MTV."
So I lost my best friend, which is bananas. And I was like, yeah, that is crazy because, you know, Nani just lost. And, you know, their original season was the same season. And then I realized he meant actually Johnny Bananas. Not like, bananas, this is crazy. I just thought that was funny. I'm going to start a separate challenge podcast where somebody is more engaged with the show than you.
Yeah, someone has... You can talk to someone who has an opinion about this.
Yeah, that's maybe a good idea. We're in the year of Sandra. That's the important thing. Heroes versus villains in a few weeks. All winners in the spring. I told my dad the 40th season of Survivor was going to be all winners, and he didn't react at all.
It's hard to get a read on him there, huh?
Yeah, I'm like, why do you not care about this more? Anyway, you can follow us on...
Why do you care about my interests?
You can follow us on Twitter at DYWSLN. You can follow me at Jake Shagdell. This is where you say yours,
follow
Thomas.
Me at Tom, not Tom.
Okay. Review us on Apple Podcasts. You want to give it a review, the baseline review again? So people will actually do it this time?
I do it every episode. Let's give them a week off.
Okay. I mean, you definitely don't do it every episode. I wouldn't have to ask, but whatever. Have a great summer.
Deuces.
Sandra, Sandra sings a bird song. Fly so much, her wings are strong. Take the scatter from the flyer. Let her down and my fun is gone. All the junkies left to cry. All the junkies wave goodbye. Laugh and cry. Heavy to lie. When the earth dies, we wish we'd died. Need to find my Latin lover and to find my powdered wig. When the police tear us into, I'll wear the custom, I'll dress in it. All the jailbirds left to cry. All the jailbirds say goodbye. Laugh and cry. Heavy to lie. When the earth dies, we wish we'd died.
We did it.